Good afternoon, students. Now we see the next theory lecture, farm planning. Very, very important concept in farm management. So what is farm planning? What it includes? Okay, what is the definition of farm planning? Farm planning refers to setting the objectives and actions to be taken in directing or controlling the organization of farm business, and it precedes all other managerial functions on the farm to achieve the desired results. So this is very, very important. In planning, we determine certain objectives or actions. Okay, in that also we consider some of the management functions like direction, controlling. Okay, this is all related with the farm business. We have to achieve the desired results, means if we have to achieve maximum profit from that farm business, then we have to follow such type of farm planning. It is deciding in advance. What is farm planning? We decide in advance the production management problems, namely what to produce, how to produce, when to produce, financial management problems like how to borrow, how much to borrow, when to borrow, where to borrow, and marketing management problems, namely where to buy and sell, when to buy and sell, and how to buy and sell. So these are the different management problems we decide in advance in which particular concept? Farm planning. Farm planning governs the survival progress and prosperity of farm organization in a competitive and dynamic environment. It is a continuous and unending process. Very, very important point. This process is continuous. Now here in this slide, I also mentioned some other definitions related with the farm planning concept. In that first one, farm planning is as old as farming itself, but mainly it is used to be informal planning. With agriculture becoming more complex business, the scientific planning, which is systematic, written, and based on best information available and aimed at achieving maximum satisfaction for the farming family from the given resources, is needed. Farm planning has to incorporate changing technological developments, physical and economic situations, and price structures. Hence, farm planning may be defined as the process of making decisions regarding the organization and operation of farm business so that it results in a continuous maximization of net returns of a farm business. We have to focus on which returns, not gross returns, but we have to focus in planning process how to maximize the farmer's net returns. Net means net profit. Okay. Now, the next point, types of farm plans. In that, there will be two types of farm plan, simple farm planning. So, what is simple farm planning? It is adopted either for a part of the land or for one enterprise or to substitute one resource to another. This is very simple and easy to implement. The process of change should always begin with this simple plan. Now, second type, complete or whole farm planning. This is the planning for whole farm. This planning is adopted when major changes are contemplated in the existing organization of farm business. Means we have to follow major changes, long-term changes in existing your farm business. Okay, then you have to go for complete farm planning. Otherwise, for part of that particular enterprise, okay, or for substitution of one resource for other, you can go for simple farm planning. So this is the difference between simple farm planning and complete farm planning. Now, this question is very important for exam point of view, characteristics of good farm plan. So number one, it should be written, it should be flexible, then it should provide for efficient use of resources, Farm plan should have balanced combination of enterprises. Such combination in turn ensures profit also, income also, production of food, cash and fodder crops. This is also comes under enterprise combination. Maintain soil fertility, increase in income, improve distribution and use of labor, power, water requirement throughout the year, and avoid excessive risk. This is the another characteristics of that plan. Then utilize farmer's knowledge and experience and take account of his likes and dislikes. Provide for efficient marketing, provision for borrowing, using and repaying repayment of credit, and provide for the use of latest technology. So these are the different important parameters. Based on these parameters, you have to prepare your farm plan. Okay, so these criteria must be followed in that particular farm plan. So this is the information of how to prepare good farm plan. Okay, which are the different types of farm plan. Okay, and definition of farm plan. Thank you.